Welcome everybody to how to install TerraTech mods. In order to do so, you need the TerraTech mod manager. There will be a link in the description where you can go and download it. It's just on the TerraTech forum. I'm not sure, but you may need to create an account before you're actually able to do so. In a second, I'm going to explain to you how you can install the TerraTech mod manager 2 for Windows. Because that way you can definitely not do anything wrong, but personally I do use the TerraTech Mod Manager GTK, which is probably a little bit easier to use because you have the GitHub mods on a separate tab, so it will be easier for you to see all of your mods you've got installed and where you can install new ones. Installation process is pretty much or exactly the same, so if you follow the steps I lay out in the video, it should still work. You can find the latest build here, TerraTech Mod Manager 2 releases. That's where we go. Here we are on GitHub, and then you just click on the executable.zip. Then it should download it for you. Simply extract the zip file, then you will have executable and then TerraTech Mod Manager. Double click the exe, then it will ask you for the location of TerraTech. Easiest way to find that if you have your own place set up for that in Steam, right click on TerraTech, then manage, and then browse local files. Then on the top you will have the nice path where it says TerraTech. You click that, you do copy that, Control C, and then in the TerraTech mod manager you paste that. Then you say continue, and for me it will already show everything here that I have installed. Then if you just want to find a couple of nice mods, just look through the GitHub section because the local section will be empty for you. Then there you will find all kinds of nice things, like some of the ones I have. If you want to also use custom blocks, I do believe you will need the Nutera block injector library. Possibly also the Nutera UI, but I don't know about that. Once you have those two both installed, or one of them, once you have your mods in the TerraTech Mod Manager installed, you will be able to go onto the TerraTech forum. Then when you're on the unofficial mods page, then you can just click the custom blocks sticky thread, and there you will have a lot of amazing block packs and blocks available for you. Of course you can also just search for ones or look ones up that you know other people have, but for instance here we have the Legionites tech blocks. Then you will have to find a Dropbox or download link like this one, and in the case of tech I believe it is also on the Steam Workshop, although most block boxes are not, I think. Once you're on the Dropbox, in this case for the tech pack, download for instance tech pack 0.4.3 or 0.5, whatever you want, and once you have that downloaded, open the place where you have it downloaded. Also open up your TerraTech position again, and you should see custom blocks and custom textures here in TerraTech. And in custom blocks you will, for instance, see here the tech pack 0.4.2 is the one I have, and you can just extract it here. Because, for instance, here we have the tech blocks main, in there you have the textures as well, so it's not as if you need to put the textures in custom textures. Custom textures is actually for skins rather than the textures of the blocks themselves, as far as I know. And once you have all of the blocks in the custom blocks folder, you can just go ahead and open up your TerraTech, and you will see that loading everything will take quite a lot longer, especially if you have a lot of blocks or a lot of mods installed. In this case I may have actually forgotten to open up TerraTech Mod Manager, which you sometimes for some reason have to do. Not always, but sometimes. Here in the top left you will see loading GUI loaded blocks, loading JSON images, and the reason it takes this long for me is mainly because for some reason my laptop has a really weird quirk that loading anything just makes it unresponsive. I don't know why. After a while it just started happening and I have not been able to find what the reason for it is. So with a bit of luck it should actually load faster for you than it is currently loading for me. Let's continue in R&D labs. And if it doesn't crash, that probably means that it's all good. And it didn't crash. That means it is all good. And then here you will have your TAC Zorg missile launcher. You should also have this one available. And for all of the other blocks, it's the same process. Other mods, like the ones I have in my description, are just download them from the TerraTech mod manager. And if you're after a while like, okay, I don't want to play with this certain block pack anymore because I don't like it, or it's just not working, you can just delete it or move it to somewhere else where TerraTech will not actually see them anymore. And of course, everyone should have this mod installed. The mod which gives you bacon. Probably the best one ever. That's how you install mods and custom blocks in TerraTech. Same way as you do the mods, you can also install skins like the Hawkeye Air Force, the Blue, and some modded blocks like the ones from TAC will actually be able to work with it. If I for instance go to this Geocorp and Lemon Kingdom and I would say, okay, I want a Geocorp skin on it, and I do click, then the Lemon Kingdom will not go with it. While the TAC does. So it is a bit mod dependent if you will be able to paint the blocks or not. I hope this video was helpful for helping you install mods in TerraTech. Of course, this is only on the PC version and not actually on consoles. But well done that you made it this far into the video. Consider watching the video in your lower left. But that's all I'm going to have for you today, and I'll see you in another video. Bye. Maybe consider watching videos where I use a couple of TerraTech mods.